Hi people, welcome to Tots and Moms. My name is Kavita and today's video I'm going to talk about disability etiquette, the way we need to behave with people with disability and the way we need to teach our kids to behave. When my child was 5 years old, we watched the movie Soul Surfer together. It was not intentional that I chose that movie, but I just read that it was an inspiring movie and we were watching it together. It is a story of a surfer who was around 10-12 years old, and she is one of the best in the city, and she and her best friend were practicing surfing then, and she saw that there was a shark coming to attack her friend. She went there to save her and she lost her leg to a shark. Now, this was heart-wrenching. I and my daughter were really in tears. I mean, that girl got all that support which was needed from her father, mother, brothers, and the best friend, and she bounced back very early, I would say. And while watching this movie, I understood that how important a support system is to nurture such souls, to make them confident, to make them independent and proud about whatever their life is about. So I was really enlightened by that movie, and it was very important for me to educate my child and people around that we need to treat them with love and acceptance, and they are inclusive and they are very much part of our society. There are certain do's, don'ts and how to educate our children about disability, which I'll be talking in the video. Please do consider watching it till the end. At first, we need to explain them that each child, a human being, is different mentally and physically. We have been teaching them that these are our parts of body. Human body is to be like that. We also need to tell them about disability. There can be certain aspects where each human being is different and there may be certain things missing in somebody. And it is absolutely okay because they still are part of the society. And an important part, explaining this to a young child can be very difficult, but it is not something that is impossible. We need to tell them that each human being is different. Mentally, somebody is strong, they can quickly grasp few things and make tables, and some people need more time, and again physical ability varies. If your friend can lift 40 kg, some people cannot even lift 20 kilos at the same age, weight and all, and some people come with all organs which is mentioned in the body diagram which we go through from our childhood, and some may or may not have some things mentioned here. Now we need to tell them that disability is just one part of their identity. It can never be their identity. They can also be a father, a sister, they may also be good at music, they can also be having a hobby, leading a lifestyle just like we do. So we need to accept them, we need to love them, we need to shower them the respect they ought, and in all the ways when we say them that they are part of society, we also need to understand that there is a very thin gap when you educate your child that they are like us. We cannot tell that they are exactly like us because they come with lots of challenge. Their life is indeed difficult and we can make it better for them. I really feel books are always a better way to elaborate topics to children, to tell them in a way they can understand, and the author has already done the duty of taking care of minute things which can hurt a child or can be easier for a child. So I'll tell you, Wings to Fly is story of para-athlete Malathi Holla. You can read that. Flute in the Forest, it is the story of a 13-year-old girl who loves music and has polio. And Manya Learns to Roar is a story of a girl with stammering. And Catch the Cat, it is a story of a girl searching her pet on a wheelchair. In all these books, what I loved the most was the story were around the characters, but it was never intentionally showcased that the character has some disability, or the disability is the identity of the character. So these books are a great way to tell them that, tell them how to behave with them, tell them the limitations they may have, and tell them how strong-willed they will be. I strongly believe there are so many don'ts, and I have made a list of do's against them. At first, do not stare. Do smile if need be, if you made an eye contact only. And now, in a mall one day, I saw a group of women around 30-ish watching another lady who had some disability. They were literally staring at her as if they saw somebody naked on the road. So it can be really heart-wrenching for that person. You don't have to do that. You really, really don't have to do that, because you are disrespecting the person's ability, and you don't know how much it can be hurtful. Next is, do not pity or underestimate. Treat them with utmost respect, because if they have come out on the street, school, college, educating themselves, working for themselves, it means that they have learned to live this life. Now, the article was written with a point of view on how we will teach it to children, but now I think I am moving towards how we need to treat them, because our kids consider us as their role models. More than we saying it to them, they watch us and learn from us. So I think it is, even this drift is good somehow. So words like, how sad they are not able to walk, how sad that fellow does not have one leg, how awful, why did God do this to him, and things like this, we should never talk. Pity and sympathy is not something they would expect. They would really want your love and acceptance. And recently I saw this Shabana Azmi, and I will put the link below in the description if I find out. I mean, it's most famous short movie. So Shabana Azmi and a woman, an acid attack victim. So we should not use the word victim. Acid attack survivor. Okay, I would not edit this face, because this is what we need to do. We do not have to victimize the person, but we need to strongly talk about them. So this acid attack survivor and Shabana Azmi's story, it is this girl joins a company, and there she's an artist in an ad agency, and all the time the whole agency, her colleagues, her senior were talking about she getting the job because she is a survivor, not because of her ability to do the job. Even the CEO wanted to showcase her on the board on saying that we are inclusive, we will have such people as well in our office, things like that, which is not really her identity. Disability can never be somebody's identity, and they never want that. Do not bully or gossip. The worst thing anybody can do is this. Oh, she does not have an eye. Look at her husband. How smart he is. Why did he marry such a lady? He could have got anybody. What do you mean by anybody? It was his wish, his love towards her. You are blind. You are not able to see that. So if you cannot talk good about anybody, please do not talk bad. Gossiping, bullying, dangerous. Next thing is, do not use cruel terms. I mean, it's only terms, but somehow I want to add this word cruel to it. In this era, you cannot say he is physically handicapped. He is specially abled. So words matter a lot to such people. Now, while talking, hey, last time you had bought one of your friend. Remember, he does not have one leg. How is he now? Instead of saying this, I would put it in a way. Last time to Mantri Mall, you had come with one of your friend. I forgot his name. How is he? Tell me more about him. So you can ask his name. I would still shout and say they are not dumb, deaf, blind. This is not their identity. They have a name. So try and figure out their name and call them with that. This is going to be respectful. Now, last but not the least, ask if they need help. Do not jump to help. A person who's out walking independently in this society, traffic, mall, school, college, anywhere, definitely would have learnt certain skills of living independently. Now, I understand you want to help them, but you need to be respectful if they need that. Maybe they are feeling that you are sympathizing them and you are not. They will not like it. So ask them. See, if you see somebody... who needs help in such ways, not able to walk well, please go up to them and ask them, would you want me to put your bag inside this car? Or if a person has vision concerns, then go to them, ask them, do you want me to help you cross the road? Do you want me to find an auto for you? So on the whole, would say this is simple yet very important for us to understand and help our children understand that they are definitely part of our society. There is nothing wrong in them. Yes, they come with a lot of challenges. We need to love them, support them in all the way possible, and never do whatever I have mentioned till now. And after watching that movie, watching as well, Disha had a lot of questions. Oh, she lost her leg. Mama, how will she even go to school? How will she walk? How will she sit? How will she go to washroom? There were many things. You need to be bold enough to tackle it in a better way. Please do not use terms or in a wrong way or just, just not talking about is also not good. So I hope in some way this video is helpful in doing this bit, and let me know in the comment section, and I'll see you soon in yet another video. I'm talking about puberty in the next video, how to talk to young children about this and what is it in boys and girls and how do we deal with it and certain things. So do watch the video, and I'll see you soon in yet another one. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye bye.